gentlemen. I am Nick Evdokimov. We are continuing our video series dedicated to the process of investing in tokens, ICO, crypto startups, and blockchain startups. Today's topic will be dedicated to the analysis of documentation needed by a startup during an ICO. What documents will we be looking at? First of all, we are talking about the white paper and what it has to include. White paper must include three important components. The first component is the token itself, which is the main object of interest to investors. The second component that must be included in the white paper is the business description, which is the relationship between the business and the market. And it should also have the potential of the business within the market and the innovations it introduces. The third component must identify the startup's core team members. It is important for the core team members to be introduced to investors so that investors may be able to analyze the team in order to see if it is ready and able to conduct an ICO and run the business itself. It's important because the ICO is just the first step the startup takes before it is launched into the real world. What should we pay attention to? We need to pay attention to the description of the said three components: the description of the token, the description of the business model, as well as the core team. We also need to understand that the description of the token has a number of aspects related to it. The first one is the token economy, which needs to demonstrate how the token demand will be created. Another important one is how the startup deals with the token supply on the market. In other words, we pay attention to how it decreases the number of tokens in circulation. The point is self-explanatory. Another aspect that needs to be outlined relates to the decrease, or an increase rather, of the token supply. What distribution program or bounty program does the startup have? Meaning, what is the startup's uncontrolled volume of tokens in circulation after the end of the ICO? For instance, if we notice that more than 20 to 25% of tokens are set aside to be distributed outside the investor circle, this is already a borderline situation for a startup. It must be understood that the business model should allow the startup to provide strategies to hold and freeze tokens. This way, the startup can reduce an uncontrollable dump of its tokens. This all just shapes the overall importance of the distribution program that is described in the white paper. The next aspect to consider in the token description is technology. We need to understand how the token is built and implemented. Hopefully, the token is built on the Ethereum platform, which works very well. We have covered this object in our previous video. And of course, we need to pay attention to the legal aspect of a startup as well. We need to keep in mind that after the token is issued, it must be listed on the market, whether it is the startup's own market platform or an outside marketplace. And that's where the purchase of tokens can occur, as well as the diffusion of users and the user database expansion. Those are some of the most important components of the white paper. The diligence applied to the white paper by the startup directly relates to the ability of the startup to run business after it is launched. This will ultimately result in giving investors a peace of mind. In addition, if the white paper is prepared professionally and is translated into many languages, it indicates that all the pre-operational work is conducted in a competent manner. As a result, there is a good chance that the rest of the work will be of high quality as well. Another important document that a startup needs to provide is called one-pager. The one-pager is a short presentation of the startup. It is usually a one-page document, however, it is oftentimes more than one page and can be as long as 3 or 4 pages. Unlike the one-pager, the white paper contains an abundance of detailed information. As a result, it is a larger document that requires more time to analyze. The analysis of white paper may require experts, and I always advise to get outside experts when possible to review white papers. As an expert myself, I help many investors with questions they have about white papers belonging to some startups they hope to invest into. Of course, first of all, I analyze one pager and then I turn to white paper because one pagers may not provide sufficient information about a startup. Even though the one pager does not provide a deep presentation of the startup, I still recommend that potential investors see if it contains the following points. The first one is about the token economy and the circulation of their supply and demand. We can see where the demand comes from and how the balance of supply and demand is created. This means that the one-pager has to show how the token supply will decrease and the demand will grow. The second point that needs to be covered in the one-pager is where the demand itself comes from. We need to see whether it is created by the business itself, by its characteristics that may be built on the theory of economic justification or a financial model of some type. We should see a brief outline of this in the one-pager, which should describe a particular market for us and the solutions that this particular startup offers through its business. We should see the token as the core element of the business, as it will demonstrate where the demand for it comes from. The third aspect we need to see in the one-pager is the team. The team needs to comply with certain demands. We understand that any business problem is solved by a variety of solutions. Every business has many important aspects such as technology, legal issues, management, sales, marketing, and many others. Also, there are issues related to the industry that this business is in. If this is a construction business or a movie production company, it will need experts in those specific fields. These experts should have many years of expertise in their fields, and these are the grounds that we can call them experts to begin with. With this in mind, we need to analyze the expertise that every team member brings in for the startup. To make things easier, we can draw a circle with different areas of expertise, such as the legal sector, marketing, and so on. We should look at a startup where there is a technology sector, which is the blockchain, and there is, for example, a high load, meaning that the service will be a multi-user one. After drawing a circle, we can indicate which team member covers which sector in our illustration, and which advisor should contribute to it. We always analyze these factors using our own scoring system as well as the scoring from outside sources. These factors are important because regardless of how beautiful the idea may seem or how high the market demand is, there is always a human factor involved and it needs to be analyzed. Another document which stands somewhere between the one pager and the white paper in size is a presentation. It is usually done by the team and is used to pitch the project to the investors. The startup explains the project to various funds, to token holders, and points out what the key goal of their business is and how the token is connected to it. This presentation is a significant part of the story and we should understand that. The story should be outlined in the presentation and provide the overall idea of the business. This part of the documentation requires close attention. Now let's look at the set of descriptions that need to be posted on the landing page. The landing page is a binding structure for the startup online. The landing page is a collection of all the documents for the startup and can be conveniently accessed. This is an intermediate format between the one pager and the white paper in terms of volume of information. So we have this set of tools, the landing page and three documents that can be downloaded, the white paper, the one pager, and the presentation. What else do we need to pay attention to and what other documents do we need to understand? It is very important that we analyze legal opinion, which is provided by lawyers who work on the token structure. Legal opinion informs potential investors that the token is complying with all legal market standards regardless of whether it is a utility or a security token. It is important to have the legal documentation confirming the legal stability of the business and the ICO itself. It is also important to see where the token issuer is registered and to have access to this registration documentation. For instance, if a token issuer is registered in the Singapore jurisdiction, we need to know the registration numbers to make sure that the founders of the project have a connection to this registration. We always need to request these documents from a startup. Once we have received them, they need to be analyzed. It's a good way to see the startup's transparency and a good test to make sure it's not a scam or a fraud. Again, when it comes to legal opinion, we need to understand that besides us, it will be requested by the cryptocurrency exchanges during the token listing. The listing of a token is an integral part and we want everything to work well in this scenario. Also, if in addition to these basic documents, the startup acquires some positive feedback about its work and obtains memorandums of intentions or signed agreements with funds related to the sale of its tokens, this shows that the business model is working well. In any case, we always have to take all documents that a startup offers and analyze them. If a startup goes to a roadshow, do not hesitate to analyze it as well. There are a lot of companies that organize roadshows, and if the startup signed a contract with them and can provide documentation as evidence, do not hesitate to analyze it as well. Also, always pay attention to memorandums signed with funds because funds buy tokens in bulk and they participate in the life of the startup by helping to sell tokens and increase the user base. It is never a bad idea to look at these contracts. There is also the tech aspect, and there is also a number of references that you need to look at. Most often, the code of the smart contract is published on GitHub along with the description and other assisting documents. We need to have access to these links, be able to see them and use them. So I recommend to look at the technical side of the documentation, maybe not read too much into it, but to take note. So all this shows transparency that you have links to the technical documentation, the white paper and the landing page available and the GitHub link. Every startup must have an agreement with an escrow service. The role of an escrow can be performed by a law firm, a company that offers legal services. They often provide escrow services as they insure accounts and provide a deposit account to place funds into. If we are talking about escrow for cryptocurrencies and not fiat funds, there should be agreements with cryptocurrency escrow services through individuals who are well known in the industry or through professional agencies that offer the service. The documentation we are talking about needs to be comprehensive, and if we do not see some significant points, we have the right to request it directly from the startup's team. Very often, startups do not publish information such as the business model or their P&L. But we also need to understand that we invest in their token, which is built and directly linked to their business model itself. That is why we can confidently request any information we need. I recommend taking 4 to 5 hours, or as long as it takes, to thoroughly analyze all documents available, such as the business plan and other papers. As the last resort, you can use agencies for this analysis or professionals who are successful investors. Often, such agencies are affiliated with investment funds and are under their management. So you can ask funds directly to make the analysis of a startup. Another option is to ask experts like myself, who have vast experience in investing and analyzing startups before making your own investments in tokens. I have always enjoyed providing such recommendations, and I work with investment funds a lot, where I am a member of the investment committee that selects startups to invest into tokens. However, I do work with individual investors as well, because people who invest from $100,000 will benefit from my consultation, and it's important to not make any mistakes when you're investing. So please do request the maximum amount of documentation and ask any questions directly to the startup's team. If you did not receive an answer to your main question as to how the token economy works, meaning what causes the token demand to grow and why supply decreases, then you need to interview the startup and request answers directly. If you have any doubts that the project team will accomplish their goal, ask more questions. Also, do not forget that during an ICO, a startup has a lot of social media activity. It has a Facebook page, a Google Plus page, and other social media sites. Using this information, you can analyze what is happening. A startup often uses Telegram, WeChat, and other messengers to link potential investors and project founders. Pay attention to this as well. Also, pay attention to the number of subscribers and analyze how the startup answers tough questions from investors. So, if we do not analyze all aspects of a startup in depth, it may lead to a serious problem and your expectations will not be met. I always advise to pay attention to everything we talked about today. In our next video, we will be looking at an example of an actual startup, which will be our final video in the series dedicated to investing in tokens. Through this example, we will briefly review all our previous editions so that you have a clear picture, sort of a quick movie, of everything, which will be a manual or a quick guide to analyze startups. Thank you very much for your attention. For more detailed information about me and my video series, please go to my website at evdokimov.com. I will be happy to answer your questions directly, and all my contact information is listed on the website as well. Thank you very much again.